again. Always a pleasure to have you here. She's going to give us an update on the labor market here in Oakdale and probably a little bit around the area or whatever, but welcome.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. We had a data release today in our office as well, so you'll get a little snapshot of what you will likely be reading about in tomorrow's newspapers. Since I've presented to many of you before, you know that I work for Minnesota's Labor Market Information Office. We produce a lot of the state's economic statistics about the workforce. We produce the unemployment rate, wages, salaries, job projections to assist not only businesses in understanding the trends that are happening in the economy, but also to assist job seekers who are making career choices. I was mentioning to Dave that we have several major projects on our agenda for next year, which are really quite exciting. We produce a lot of the demand information, what employers are looking for, how many job openings they have, and we'll be linking that to supply data. So graduates of programs, and are they finding employment in what industries at what wages? So it's a new area of data for us that we're calling right now Better LMI. We're very excited about it. Our job trend overview is current as of July, so in a couple more weeks you'll get the August data. So right now the news has certainly been good for Minnesota. We've added over 71,000 jobs in the state compared to where we were last July. We're about 5,500 jobs short of the 160,000 jobs that Minnesota lost during the recession. So we have regained about 95% of the jobs lost. Nationally, they're sitting at about 75%, needing to gain about 2 million more jobs to get at that pre-recessionary job level. Our growth rate is surpassing the national average, 2.6% compared to 1.7%. And in July, our unemployment rate held steady at 5.2% compared to the 7.4% rate we saw across the country. And a lot of the leading indicators that we look at include what's happening to job openings. The Conference Board's Help Wanted Online Index tracks the number of jobs that are posted online. Minnesota's ranking 7th among states right now with the best ratio, the Twin Cities metropolitan area ranking 5th. We also saw that the number of jobs in employment services, which is the sector that includes temporary staffing agencies and employment service firms, continued to add more jobs, reaching an all-time high. And for us, that's often a really great indicator of job growth, the business community, especially after a recession. And finally, our seasonally adjusted claims for unemployment insurance benefits fell once more to another monthly low that we haven't seen since January of 2001, which is before the recession, before the Great Recession. So we're seeing extremely low numbers of unemployment insurance claims in Minnesota.
Where are you seeing the growth as far as more jobs? What industry?
We're going to get right to that. Yeah.
His first time.
Give me a snapshot of what this looks like across Minnesota. The Minneapolis-St. Paul metropolitan area is by far leading job growth across the state at 3.7%. The St. Cloud area is the only other metro region where we've seen more than just a few hundred jobs added over the year. So our strength here in the Twin Cities is certainly relevant in the numbers that came out in July. Where we're actually seeing the growth, and this is going to take some explanation for a couple of these industry sectors, do include professional and business services, which here in the Twin Cities dominates a lot of our employment. These are jobs in architecture, engineering, computer systems design, legal services, a lot of the very high-paying, high-tech jobs. Government appears second on the list, and this is quite unique. While the private sector continued to add jobs in 2001 and 2002, the public sector actually continued to lose jobs until July of 2012. So this July of 2013, we actually have seen some pretty strong growth in government and particularly local government education. And that is particularly true in the Twin Cities. We'll see next month if this rights itself, because July is usually not the month that local school districts begin hiring, although we know that the local school districts were infused with some state monies and that we've just heard anecdotally that many are ramping up their hiring of paraprofessionals to staff all-day kindergartens. Also on that list to note is education and health services, which has been a sector that has generally increased from month to month during this recession and even dating back to the early 2000s. We continue to see growth in the healthcare sector, both in ambulatory healthcare, which is clinics, offices of doctors and dentists, nursing homes, social assistance, where we have seen some significant decline over the years, private sector education. And financial activities has also been growing across the state. That's everything from commercial banking, insurance companies, realtors, and that's a welcome sign for us since that is one area where we continue to like national growth. And I'll mention the manufacturing sector, which is the glaring weak spot in our jobs data. Overall, we've seen job loss compared to last July of about 2,500 jobs. And this is largely coming from our non-durable section, non-durable goods manufacturing sector, so food manufacturing, printing. On the flip side, fabricated metal products, medical device companies have been seeing job growth. And having looked at the sector very closely for a local reporter, we are noticing a difference between growth in rural manufacturing and growth here in the Twin Cities. There are a couple of regions that are doing really well in expanding their manufacturing employment. We can take a closer look at what's happening in the city of Oakdale, and I think without question we have seen the city rebound from its recessionary lows. Employment on average in 2012 was 8,470. We saw employment in the city decline by 5.5% during the recession. It's grown 8% in 2010, 5% in 2011, 4% in 2012. So we're seeing private employment in Oakdale at its highest level that we record in this data series. There's 612 business establishments that we account for in these data, which are establishments and jobs that are covered under unemployment insurance. So this doesn't include people who might be self-employed or work as contractors or consultants for other companies. We can take a step further into the data and look at what your leading industries in the city are. And this number, or this listing, has pretty much stayed consistent as I've presented to you over the years. Retail trade makes about 16% of private sector employment in the city, accommodation and food services at 12%, healthcare and social assistance at 10%, manufacturing, finance, and insurance at 10% as well. If we just look over the last 2 years of annual average growth here in Oakdale, we've seen the largest growth in the healthcare and social assistance sector. And when I take a closer look into that industry, it looks like clinics and offices of doctors and the nursing home and residential care facilities sector, which has seen the most growth. And on the declining industry side, administrative and support services has seen the largest number of job declines, and manufacturing is on that list as well, with a net loss of 46 jobs between 2010 and 2012 in the city. We also produce, as you saw, unemployment rate statistics. And as many of you know, the unemployment rate measures something very precise. It's people who are available and actively seeking work. These data are computed through national household surveys that are conducted, so are independent of people who are receiving unemployment insurance claims. We did see the labor force participation rate fall in July to one of the lowest levels since the early 1980s. So we know that some people continue to be discouraged from the process of looking for work, or are taking advantage of other opportunities like getting some additional training, which is an added benefit when they do return to our workforce. If we added in people who were discouraged or had some temporary barrier from taking a position, Minnesota's unemployment rate would increase from about 5.2%, about 1 percentage point more. We can also look at county level and even city level unemployment rates for our large Minnesota cities. And Washington County sits about in the middle of the Twin Cities counties with an unemployment rate of 4.7%. That's down from 8.2% at its peak in 2009. For the city of Oakdale, and this would be referencing people that are residents of Oakdale, there's about 842 people that we classify as unemployed through those national household surveys for an unemployment rate of 5.2%. And city unemployment rates have been relatively low here in Washington County. On the map, Brooklyn Center is the city that stands out with the highest unemployment rate amongst Twin Cities cities at 6.2%. Ramsey, Anoka, and Hennepin County have unemployment rates of 5% or higher in July. And I mentioned that we released some new data today. It has to do with our job vacancies, which is a data set that we have tracked for the past 13 years on a semi-annual basis. We are reporting that Minnesota employers had about 72,000 job openings during the second quarter of this year, which is the highest we've seen on record since the second quarter of 2001. So we are seeing evidence in these numbers as well of some strong job growth and hiring activity. We track not only the quantitative but qualitative aspects of job openings and do recognize that about 45% of these openings are part-time, 16% are temporary, and then about 43% of job openings require some post-secondary education or training. Here in the Twin Cities, we had about 60% of those job openings, about 42,000, with healthcare and social assistance, accommodation, food service, and retail trade showing some of the largest numbers of openings. You will likely read more in the newspapers tomorrow.
Rachel, how would that $12.50 an hour median compare? Is that higher or lower than normal?
It's actually a really great question, and probably the story that we'll see tomorrow. It did turn out to be a little bit lower than it has been, and in part because we're seeing larger numbers in retail, trade, and accommodation food service openings.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And of course, this is reflective of all job openings. We can even break all of these statistics down by those that are part-time, those that are full-time, or considered permanent.
So maybe the quality of those jobs is a little less than what we've seen?
Well, we're certainly seeing more job openings, and some of those job openings are at those lower wages.
Entry-level.
Exactly.
Yeah.
With that, happy to take any other questions you have, or the last slide I always include is my contact information. It's always a pleasure for me to present here at the City of Oakdale, and I can be of assistance to you in whatever capacity you need. That's our expertise as regional labor market analysts for DE. So thank you.
Any other questions for Rachel? Well, thank you very, very much. Very informative as always. It's always good to have you here too. So
thank you.
Feel free to be here anytime. Thank you again.
Yeah.